A continuous real function f satisfies the identity f of 2x is equal to 3 times f of x for all x. If the integral from 0 to 1 of f of x is 1, what is the value of the integral from 1 to 2 f of x?
And at first, I thought this was a really hard question because I was really amazed by the solution that they provide and I couldn't come with that solution on my own. But I would still like to show you guys what that solution is first though, so have a look. Right here, they started by calling this to be S, but I don't like to use S because my S looks like a 5, so let's use I for integral. And then we are going to make some observations. Not the integral going from 1 to 2 and not the integral going from 0 to 1 though, but rather the integral going from 1 half to 1 of the function f of x. And we are going to see why right now. Because we have f of x right here, and we can use this relationship after we divide the 3 on both sides, so we know this is the integral going from 1 half to 1, and we will have f of 2x over 3, and then we are still in the x world. And now you see the input is 2x, so it's a good idea to do some use up, and that's why we started with 1 half to 1, and then you will see it works out pretty well. Alright, so I'm going to let you equal to the inside, which is 2x, and then we can just divide the 2 on both sides and then differentiate both sides. We can see that dx is equal to du over 2. So the integral is going to be, here we have the 1/3, let's put it in the front, and then this is x going from 1 half to 1. After this substitution, we will just say u goes from 1 to 2, right? Multiply this and that by 2. And then we have f of 2x, which is now the f of u, and then the dx is just du over 2. And now check this out. 1 half can be brought up to the front as well, and we multiply that with 1 over 3, so we get 1 over 6. And we have the integral going from 1 to 2, f of u du. This is exactly that. The dummy variable doesn't matter. And one way to see that is, you can just interpret this as the area under the curve f of x or f of u. They have the same area, regardless which variable that you use. So we can say the rest is just 1 over 6 times I. Cool. Now we continue with the same fashion. Look at the integral going from 1 over 4 to 1 over 2. Again, we divide this and that by 2 because similar things will happen. So here, let's go ahead, put down f of x dx, and this is the integral, and we will just have 1 over 4 to 1 half, and again, this will be f of 2x divided by 3, and then we have the dx. And we are going to use the same substitution. This time though, we have 1 over 6 just like earlier, but this integral is the integral going from 1 half to 1 of the function f. So it's not just I, but rather we will have to utilize what we did earlier. So the rest of the integral here is actually 1 over 6i, like so. And now we can see that this right here is just going to be 1 over 6 squared times I. Cool. And you can imagine we can just keep on going with the same thing, right? So the next one that we will do is just the integral going from 1 over 8 to 1 over 4 of the function f of x dx. And we will get 1 over 6 to the third power here, and then multiply that by I. Yeah, and then so on, so on, so on. And in general, we can write down the following. The integral going from 1 over 2 to the n to 1 over 2 to the n minus 1. Because this right here is just like 2 to the 2, this is 2 to the 3rd. So this right here has one less factor of 2. And then the function f of x, dx. This right here is just going to be 1 over 6 to the nth power, and then multiply that by I. Cool. Yeah, this is it. No, what exactly is happening? What exactly have we done, right? We haven't solved the question yet. Well, let's just go back to the original given information. You always have to use the given information. If we don't use the given information, something's wrong. So the only integral that we know is this. So we want to go to from 0 to 1, right? We want to go there. Okay, we can take the limit of this, But in that case, the bottom will be 0, the top right here will be 0 as well. We don't get 1. Don't worry. You see, we do have the 1 right here. Right? This is 1 half to 1. If we combine this integral with this integral, then these two together, it will be the integral going from 1 over 4 to 1 because of the definite integral property. And then if you want to go from 1 over 8 to 1, just combine this, this and that together. So if you want to go from 0 to 1, then we just have to add up all this together and then be sure to take the limit as n goes to infinity. And let me write that down right here for you guys. And then be sure we take the limit as n goes to infinity. And now check this out. This right here will be the limit as n goes to infinity. And then the first integral is just 1 over 6i. Good. And then the next one is 1 over 6 squared times I. Yeah. And then the third one is 1 over 6 to the third power times I, and so on, so on, so on. And we have the general form, which is 1 over 6 to the nth power times I. And as we can see, everybody has the I. We can factor that out and then take the limit as n goes to infinity. We will actually get a convergent geometry series because the common ratio is just 1 over 6. So this right here becomes, we have the I, and then we multiply by the first term, which is 1 over 6, and then divided by 1 minus the common ratio, which is also 1 over 6. And then do whatever you need to do. I will tell you this right here is equal to 1 over 5, and then we will have the I right here. Cool. And then don't forget that, what's this? It's just equal to 1. So ladies and gentlemen, now we know 1 is equal to 1 over 5 times I. So multiply the 5 on both sides. I is just equal to 5. And that's the answer to this integral right here. Okay, let me tell you, if you want to learn more calculus, then I will recommend you guys to check out our sponsor today, Brilliant. We are currently looking at the integral calculus course. Here, they cover all the integration techniques that you have to know, such as integration by parts and different kinds of substitutions. Taking a course from Brilliant is really fun because they will keep you engaged by storytelling and cool animations. Over the past year, they have built a whole new platform for their courses that takes interactivity to the next level. You will see hands-on activities while you go through their courses, and especially they have over 60 interactive courses in math and science, and they range from beginning level to advanced level. So you will be able to find courses that you like and you can start learning something new. And I have a special link for you guys, brilliant.org/blackpenredpen. If you use the link, you will have a 20% off discount. So go ahead and check them out, and when you do, it will really help the channel as well. Thank you guys so much, and of course, thanks to Brilliant for sponsoring this video. And I think this is super, super cool. Yeah, I was really, really amazed by this approach. However, are you guys ready for the easier way? Yes? Okay, let's go. Here we go. We are going to first start with this integral, and let's put it down right here. The integral from 0 to 1, f of x. And we are going to do what we did earlier. That is to write f of x as f of 2x over 3. And we still have to integrate this from 0 to 1 in the x world. And right here, we can just do a u sub. And now take this integral to the u world. Well, put 0 in here, we get u is equal to 0. And put 1 in here, we get u is going to be at 2. And we have the 1 over 3 that's put in the front. And then we have f of 2x, that is f of u now. And dx is that, which is du over 2. We can put the 1 over 2 in the front, so we have, and now remember, this right here is equal to 1, so we have 1 is equal to that, and 1 is equal to this. By looking at the last equation, we can multiply both sides by 6, and this right here will tell us the integral going from 0 to 2, f. And right here we use u, but we can use t, we can use w, it doesn't matter, it's just a dummy variable. Let's use the best letter ever. That's x. So let's put down f of x, dx. All right? And that will just be equal to 6. This is so cool. Do we see it? Yeah! Guess what we're gonna do? Yeah, just go ahead and subtract. And ladies and gentlemen, on the left hand side, when we go from 0 to 2 and then subtract from 0 to 1, this right here will give us the integral going from 1 to 2. And then we have f of x. And then on the right hand side, it's just 6 minus 1. We get 5. And that's it. Ta-da! That's the answer. 5. Yeah? I come up with this. Yeah, myself. I did it myself. Yeah. But I was really impressed with the solutions that they had. I had no idea how to come up with that solution. I thought it was really beautiful. I'm still thinking. Maybe there's actually an integral like with about maybe from like 2 to 3 or so that you do have to do that kind of approach in order to get the answer, or maybe from 0 to 3. I don't know, but based on this question, this is it.